Hey everyone, very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's class. So here guys, the first question that we have is, what is the rate of minimum assured pension under the Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Manthan Yojana? So here the right answer is option D. ₹3,000 per month is the minimum assured pension given to the beneficiaries of this scheme. But first of all, why is this scheme in the news? Because it was not launched recently. The news is that recently Ministry of Labour and Employment has launched a campaign under this scheme, and that campaign is titled as Donate a Pension. So what is that campaign all about, and what are the things from this scheme that are in the news, that we will discuss here. So guys, under this Donate a Pension program, the Ministry of Labour and Employment basically tries to encourage the people to contribute to the pension fund of their unorganized sector workers, like their domestic workers or helpers. Okay, so open the pension account for them and help them and contribute some amount in their pension account. So that is basically the idea of this Donate a Pension campaign. However, under the Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Manthan Yojana, the facility for opening the pension account has been provided to the workers themselves. Okay, so if any worker wants to open his or her pension account, he or she can open that account under this scheme. And once the account is opened, the minimum amount that the beneficiary is required to deposit in the account is 660 to 2400. So this is the range between which the beneficiaries can submit or deposit the amount, and at the age of 60 years they will be given a pension of ₹3,000 per month. And now guys, this is another information given to you, and that is the Ministry of Labour has celebrated the iconic week from March 7 to 13, whereas Ministry of Women and Child Development celebrated this week from March 1st to March 8th, that is the day of International Women's Day. Okay. The next question is, by which year does the National Education Policy envisage to convert all UGC affiliated colleges into degree awarding multidisciplinary autonomous institutions? So guys, here the answer is option C, 2035. So recently the University Grants Commission has launched a draft, okay, so in order to convert all the universities, all the colleges affiliated to the UGC into multidisciplinary colleges, okay, where the degrees related to multidisciplines will be provided from different disciplines. Usually we see that a college or a university is restricted to more than 5 or 6 disciplines, but with the multidisciplinary framework in implementation, majority of the colleges, majority of the universities that are affiliated with UGC will provide education and degree in many fields. Okay, so this will definitely give a boost to the higher education ecosystem in India. Now this guys also was envisaged in the National Education Policy of 2020. I hope guys that you have covered this policy thoroughly, because this is going to stay important until or unless a new education policy comes up, okay? And in the near future, we do not think that any new policy is coming up, so you do not have any other option. You have to cover it from your exam point of view, okay? So 2035 is the year that is envisioned by this policy to convert the colleges into multidisciplinary autonomous institutions. Moving ahead to the third question, which of the following music band performed at the Swachh Griha event in New Delhi? So guys, the music band is option E, Dhruv. Okay. So recently Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Jal Shakti and Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, all these three ministries in collaboration with this Sulabh International Organization have organized this Swachh Griha initiative or event basically in New Delhi. So guys, all the points highlighted here are important for you to remember. Next, the purpose of this Swachh Griha event was to create awareness about Swachhata, about cleanliness. So that was the purpose of this Swachh Griha event that was organized in New Delhi. Now the question that is here, that is Dhruv. Okay, so Dhruv guys is the Sanskrit band, and remember that it is the world's only music band that is based on India's own traditions. Okay, that is why it becomes all the more important. So do remember, it's the Dhruva band that is the world's only band based on India's old Vedic Gaan and music traditions. So now the next question that we have is, which state has launched the Amma Yojana for non-working mothers and Bahini scheme for the girl students? So here guys, the right answer is Sikkim. Now under this Amma Yojana, rupees 20,000 will be provided to the non-working mothers in order to empower them, okay? And under this Bahini scheme, the sanitary pads will be distributed among the school girls. So this is all about these two schemes. Apart from this, don't go into too much details, okay? Next question is, recently Bombay Stock Exchange has collaborated with MSME Trade and Investment Promotion Bureau for promoting awareness among micro, small and medium enterprises of the dash state about the benefits of listing. Okay, so here guys, Tamil Nadu is the right answer. Now the other way around in which this question can be framed is that this bureau is located in which state? This bureau is the arm of which state government? Okay, so in this manner the question can be tricked, okay, can be framed in a tricky manner. Sorry. Next question is, where was the R.K. Lakshman Art Gallery Museum inaugurated by Prime Minister? Okay, so it is Pune. Along with this, many projects like Pune Metro Rail project was also inaugurated, and Symbiosis Arogya Kendra was also inaugurated. So all of these development works were inaugurated in Pune itself, and among all the projects, the important ones are this and the other ones like the Pune Metro Rail inauguration and your Symbiosis Arogya Center. So these three are the main projects. Okay. Moving ahead to the next question, which of the following grasslands is known as the breadbasket of Europe? So here guys, Steppe is the right answer, which is located in Ukraine. Okay. Now why is it in the news? Because due to the Russia-Ukraine tussle, India has made a record export of wheat this time, okay? So that is why this is in the news. Now let's have a look at the exports of wheat done by India. So India has exported a record 7 million tons till February 2022, okay? And still we have 1 month left, and in this current financial year we are going to hit the records in wheat exports. Okay, so I had already told you this fact when I covered Russia and Ukraine tussle, that Russia and Ukraine together account for approximately 1/3 of wheat exports in the international market, and with this tussle the wheat prices have been rising continuously, and therefore the buyers of the wheat have found the India's offer interesting in terms of wheat. So here, by the end of February, 6.6 million tons of wheat was exported, and 1 month is left, so approximately this much would be achieved by India. Apart from this, India has also sent 50,000 tons of wheat to Afghanistan as a symbol of humanitarian aid. Okay, apart from this, what are the economic implications of Russia-Ukraine crisis, particularly from India's point of view? Now let's discuss that. Okay, so one thing here is that all these card networks have stopped their services in Russia. So this might prove as an opportunity for India, because we have a similar kind of network, that is RuPay card network, okay? So if we promulgate that network in Russia, then obviously it is going to benefit the economy of India, okay? So that is one thing, but let's see whether India is going to take that opportunity or not at this moment, because if we look at this entire crisis, that from humanity's perspective, it is a really tragic situation, and making money out of that tragic situation, this is not something that India has done so far. Okay, this might be US business, but India has not done it so far. Let's see whether India is going to accept this or not. whether we will expand the RuPay network in Russia or not. Apart from this, Russian oil firms have also given an offer to India. Okay, so this is, guys, a discount offer of 25% to 27% on the oil prices. Now Russia is one of the major exporters of oil and gas as well, and now with the shortage, with the constriction in the supply of Russian oil, there is obviously a rise in the oil market, rise in the price of oil, and definitely it is going to impact India's economy, because 85% of our import needs are fulfilled by 85% of our crude oil needs are fulfilled by imports only. Okay, so guys, this is definitely going to increase the prices. So let's see whether India again is going to take these offers from the Russian oil firms or not. So that is all regarding the present situation in the international economy. Okay, now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following missions will conduct the research on TRAPPIST-1 system, a unique planetary system? So guys, here the right answer is James Webb Telescope, James Webb Space Telescope, that was launched in December 2021 only by NASA. On which rocket was this telescope launched? This is, guys, your question. Tell me in the comment section below, okay, the answer. Now guys, what is this system? This is nothing but like our solar system, this is another system. Okay, so James Webb Space Telescope is going to study this system, and this TRAPPIST, guys, is a star, okay, red dwarf star, and it has 7 planets orbiting it. Okay, so this makes it similar to the solar system that we have, and now we are going to study whether life exists on those planets or not, because water traces have been discovered on these 7 exoplanets of this TRAPPIST star. Okay, so apart from this, apart from the information that I have given you, what are the things that you need to know? That TRAPPIST 1 was discovered in 2017 by NASA, and it is located just 40 light years away from Earth. Okay, so this is the distance. Apart from this, we have just discussed everything related to the TRAPPIST system. So now let's move on to the next question. Which company has been chosen by RBI for getting quantum core banking solutions? So here, guys, Intellect is the right answer. This is again nothing but the solution, like the core banking solutions that Indian banking system has been working on. So this is another system that RBI is going to adopt in order to improve its infrastructure, digital infrastructure. Okay, so for that, Intellect has been chosen. This company is going to provide the solution to RBI. Next question is, which bank has sanctioned a loan of ₹1,000 crore to Jammu and Kashmir Infrastructure Development Finance Corporation Limited? So guys, here Indian Overseas Bank is the right answer. So guys, all the borrowings, all the funds that this organization gets, the Jammu Kashmir Infrastructure Development Finance Corporation gets, it puts that money into the infrastructure development of the Union Territory. And now with this grant, Indian Overseas Bank is aiming to increase the credit portfolio of itself. Okay, so that is the target, or the entire news all about. Moving ahead to the next question, who has been selected to represent India at the 2041 Climate Force Antarctic Expedition? So guys, here Arushi Verma is the right answer. So first of all, I would like to tell you what this 2041 expedition all about. So guys, 2041 is a foundation, and it conducts its expedition. The purpose of the expedition is to preserve Antarctic. Okay, now how will the Antarctic Ocean be preserved? So basically, this 2041 organization works to tackle the climate change, because climate change is one of the most we can say dangerous threats to the Antarctic. Okay, So this foundation was founded by Robert Swan, who is an environmentalist, and he is the first person to go to North Pole and the South Pole. So both of these poles have been visited by Robert Swan, and he has founded this foundation. Now understand that from India, Arushi Verma is going to join this expedition for conservation of Antarctica. Okay, so that is only written here, guys. You can read it on your own as well. Apart from this, I don't think that there is any explanation required. But guys, do remember that Arushi Verma is a shooter, pistol and trap shooting. Okay, so this can also be asked from you in the examination. So do remember. The next question is, who has been appointed as the group head of digital banking at the level of deputy MD by SBI? So guys, it is Nitin Chugh who has been appointed as the group head of the digital banking. Okay, usually we tend to cover the MDs and CEOs of the banks that are appointed recently. But why did I cover this news? Because guys, first thing, that examiners tend to ask such random questions. Secondly, it is SBI, the largest bank of India. Okay, so these are the two reasons for which I kept this news here. So pay attention, Nitin Chugh has been appointed as the digital head. Which organization has received the first prize in the Ispat Rajbhasha Award for 2018-19? So guys, National Mineral Development Corporation, NMDC, which is India's largest iron ore producer. So this company has got this award for 2018-19 and 2019-24. Both the years the same company has received the award. Okay. The next question is, which of the following award is given to the urban local body for providing improved services and facilities to women under the Nari Shakti Puraskar framework? So guys, here Mata Jijabai award is the right answer. So Jijabai, guys, was the mother of Shivaji. Okay, Maharaj Shivaji ki mother thi. Okay, and on her name this award has been constituted. Now guys, understand this thing that Nari Shakti Puraskar is one of the highest civilian order given to the individuals and institutions working for the welfare of women. Okay, so this year the award has been given for 2020 and 2021 in 28 categories. Okay, so these 28 categories are divided into 14 each. Okay, for 2020, 14 categories are there. For 2021, 14 categories are there. Total 29 people have got this award. Okay, and it is presented by President Ramnath Kovind. Now guys, when you have so many awardees, the names of the awardees do not hold that much significance. So what is the thing that can become a question in the examination? The thing is regarding the Puraskar itself. Okay, so these were started in 1999, and every year these awards are presented by the President Ramnath, the President of India. Okay, at present it is Ramnath Kovind. The cash prize is rupees 2 lakh per awardee. Now guys, under this framework only, under the Nari Shakti Puraskar framework only, these are the six categories that are given for, that are for the institutions. Okay, so first is Devi Ahilyabai Holkar Award, that is given to private and public organization working for the welfare of women. Carnegie Devi Award, given to state for improving child sex ratio. Mata Jijabai Award is given to urban local body for providing improved services to the women. Rani Gadinliu Award is given to civil society organization working for the welfare of women again. Rani Lakshmibai Award is given to institutions doing research and development for women empowerment. And Rani Rudrama Devi Award is given to district panchayats and gram panchayats. Okay, two district panchayats and two gram panchayats receive these awards annually. Okay, so these are the categories under the Nari Shakti framework. And here guys, the video ends. If you like the content provided by us, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much for watching this video.